Today we are going to build a very powerful and very sleek looking PC with some latest hardware that is aimed at gamers who also create content or professionals who want something really powerful but with a more mature taste than the usual RGB overload. This build was challenging, but the final result is totally worth it and it is really exciting to be able to share it with you all. Hey guys, I am Siddharth and let's build the Creator Gaming PC. Starting with the case, we have the very special Cooler Master SL600M. I chose this case because I was bored with the conventional layout of other cases, and while building in this case is more challenging than your average build, it is for good reasons because with a completely sealed front, the airflow on this case flows from bottom to top with these massive 200mm fans at bottom, so that is a really unique approach to case design. And it also looks really neat, so it is perfect for our professional looking build, which will accommodate some very powerful secrets. For our motherboard, we have to thank ASUS for sending this Z490 ProArt Creator 10G motherboard. It is primarily focused to be used by content creators, but that doesn't mean that you can't game on it, especially with its AI cooling and AI overclocking features that even Derbauer has said good things about. It features two Thunderbolt 3 ports and a Hyper 10GB LAN card, which you can use by inserting it in a PCIe slot like this. But the onboard LAN is also pretty fast with its 2.5GB port, so if you need to work with large files on a network, this will be really amazing. It features a nice power delivery system with a 12+2 power stage design, and the MOSFETs are covered by this simple looking heatsink, which will make it look really neat in our Cooler Master case. It also supports ProArt Creator Hub for integrating with other ProArt products, and it has some really interesting things about it, like the dual DisplayPort ports actually being dual display input ports for Thunderbolt. But we have to focus on the rest of the build too, so we will shift our attention to the CPU that we will insert into this motherboard, and it is Intel's 10-core 20-thread 10th generation Core i9-10900K that can go up to 5.3 GHz. And if you want to build the technically fastest gaming PC at the moment, this is going to be the CPU of choice. It of course supports features like Thunderbolt 3, Intel Optane storage, and performance tuning support with Intel's Extreme Tuning utility. And Intel has actually added some really interesting overclocking tech to their 10th gen CPUs, which you can check out in the reviews. Then on the top M.2 slot, we are installing a 500GB SATA SSD. And I know how people get really triggered when they see a SATA SSD these days, so we are also going to install a 512GB NVMe SSD from the very special brand Astra, which is an Indian component brand, and I have used their SATA SSD in my previous build, which really offered superior performance over its competition, so I am assuming that this NVMe SSD must also follow the trend. Here is a benchmark for it, so you can get an idea of its speed. This is really going to give us great boot up and app launch times, but we will be adding more storage later on. By the way, make sure that you are subscribed to the channel with bell icon, because we are going to have even more exciting stuff on the channel soon, and it will be really awesome to reach 50,000 subs by the end of this year. Then we will install RAM in this PC, and we need a bit more of it than usual, so we will go with 32GB of a mixed set of G-Skill Trident Z and Trident Z Royale running at 3200MHz. These two models do look very different from each other, but the actual RAM stick under the heatsink is identical, so you can mix them very easily, and personally, I do think that the mixed set looks really nice and unique, and we are going to check that out soon. Moving on to the cooler that we will use for the CPU, we have Lianli's Galahad 360 AIO liquid cooler in this amazing white color, and I would like to thank Reaper Group India for sending this cooler for the video. They are the national distributor for Lianli. This cooler looks really stunning with its aluminum CPU block, and even the fans that come with this and their cables are completely white in color, so in addition to fitting very well with our PC, this will also add some nice contrast to it. The SL600M features a removable mounting top, so we were easily able to remove that and install our radiator on this. A better way to install fan in this case is to install them over the top mounting bracket of the case, but that would have blocked the RGB lighting of the fans, which we obviously didn't want. For our PSU, we have another brand that you may not know very well, We are going to use the Superflower LeadX SE, which will deliver 1000 watts of power to our PC. And it's not just an 80 plus gold power supply, but an 80 plus platinum power supply with up to 92% of efficiency. It also has 100% Japanese capacitors, and we know that Japanese means good. Superflower has actually been the OEM for brands like EVGA, and they are especially known for their high power PSUs, which go up to 2000 watts, which is crazy. We went for a 1000 watt power supply to ensure that we don't face any issues with fitting it in our case, because it does have a more complicated than usual installation method, and even 1000 watts is overkill for the system that we are building. Then finally, coming to one of the most exciting components, the GPU that we will use is the latest NVIDIA RTX 3080 Tough Gaming OC. I have also reviewed this card recently with benchmarks, and we saw how amazing its performance is over the RTX 2080 Ti. The Tough Gaming OC specifically is also probably the best RTX 3080 to be released yet, because it features a really solid aluminum shroud and backplate, and Steve from Hardware Unboxed found that it runs 6% faster than the Founders Edition 3080 while running 15 degrees cooler with its awesome heatsink. We are mounting it vertically with the Cooler Master vertical mount, and you can actually also mount it without using this mount because the case also features a rotatable PCIe bracket, which is really cool, but to install it in that way, you need a riser cable which we didn't have. 1TB of storage is of course not going to be enough for a creator gamer, so we have a 10TB hard drive from WD. It is their gold variant, which is a data center hard drive, but it of course also works in a regular PC, but you do have to ensure that you have sufficient cooling for it, and even though this is not an SSD, it is decently fast, running at 7200 RPM, which is actually really good to have with its 10TB of space. It's also mounted in the front of this case, which is rare to see. Then we will install the Corsair Lighting Note Pro for our ARGB lighting strips, and later on, we also added Fantex Neon LED strips, because you can never have too much of RGB. We also need some neat looking custom sleeved cables in this PC, and for that, we have these carbon and silver colored cables from Tweaked PC, and these really are extremely well made, which is why they are so popular in India, and you can literally get them in any color combination and also customize the color of the combs and the connectors. The cable management space in this case isn't the best that I have seen, but we were still able to do it reasonably well. We actually removed all of the panels on this case, so let's close them up and let's see if we were able to build this PC well enough to make it able to boot on the first try. And it actually did show the BIOS screen on the first try, but it didn't boot into Windows because it showed CPU fan error because we hadn't plugged that in. But this is very easy to fix, and you can just go into BIOS in advanced mode, go to the monitor tab and select ignore on the CPU fan setting, and then we were able to boot into Windows, which I am proud of. For the peripherals, we have two 4K IPS monitors from LG, and we are using a HyperX Alloy Elite keyboard with custom PBT keycaps along with a Logitech G604 with many buttons. Creators also need professional level sound, which will be delivered by these amazing A5Xs from Adam Audio. And to get the most out of our speakers, we are also going to use the RME ADI 2 DAC FS, which also has a headphone amp powering our Hi-Fi Man HE4XX. And now let's see how the final result of our 5 hours of work looks like. And I personally really like how this build looks. What I really like is how well the cooler, the GPU and the motherboard complement each other even after being from different series like the TUF and ProArt lineup. The rest of the components also don't have a very gamery aesthetic, and you can achieve a very clean look by turning the RGB off in black SL600M. So if you are not into aggressive looks of the mainstream gaming components, something like this could be really great. I have also benchmarked this GPU in a recent video, and we have seen how big of an upgrade this is over the RTX 2080 Ti, and we are going to see a few percent better performance with this PC because we have a 10900K instead of a 9900K. You can also flex on your friends with your 10 gigabit LAN speeds, because even if you are not a creator, everyone knows how cool networking and LAN speeds are. Here's the price list if you are looking to build a similar PC, and I'll also have links in the video description if you want to check the current prices or buy them. So do let me know what you think about this build in the comment section below. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Subscribe with bell for more exciting content on PC hardware. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.